Welcome back to the Reflactor channel. I've just started the process of bringing this Maksutov Cassegrain back to its original condition. Now this has a focal length of 1.5 meters. That's pretty impressive if you consider they've squeezed all that into this tiny little package. Now the good news is that the mirror at the back and the meniscus lens up front with the tiny little secondary mirror are all in fantastic shape. The bad news is that the diagonal mirror that's in this helical focuser tube needs to be recoated. It's all scratched up. I'm gonna send it off to the same company that recoated the mirror on my 12-inch Dobsonian. If you've seen any of my International Space Station photo videos, then you've seen the results of that. It's a fantastic mirror and they did a great job. So the first step is to remove the focuser tube from the telescope, and then we'll remove the mirror from the focuser tube. All right, here we are on the workbench. Here's that focuser tube. It's actually a helical focuser. And here's a loose ring that attaches to the telescope. And it's all held together with these three screws. So let's go ahead and start taking these apart. There we go. This comes apart and it will reveal the mirror sitting right. Wait a minute, where'd the mirror go? Okay, so I have a confession to make. When I originally took this apart and used a razor blade to go around the caulking and pull the mirror off, I somehow lost that video. It is gone forever. I've searched for it, but that's the bad news. The good news is I've already had a chance to take this mirror off and send it to Majestic Optical Coatings, and it's already back. Let's go ahead and open this and take a look at what the newly coated mirror looks like. Let's go ahead and open up this box. Always cut away from you, right? Especially when it's a really dull blade. The duller the better, they say. Just kidding. That's actually terrible advice. This tiny little mirror. I'm very excited to see what this looks like. I'm not sure what kind of masking this tape is, but wow, is it tough. Holy cow. Be careful not to scrape the mirror, though. This mirror, this tape is so good. The person who runs this optical coating business, his name is Jeff Decker. He's done a really good job. I'm very excited to see this. I am going to get some lens paper out. Pick it up. This is such good packaging. Wow. Oh my gosh, look at that. That is a beautiful mirror. Wow.
If you don't already know it, telescope mirrors are very different from the mirrors that you find around your house. The reflective layer on a telescope mirror is placed on the front surface. The most common material they use is aluminum, and they use a process called vapor deposition. It's very finicky, and Mr. Decker did a great job once again.
We're going to lay that on this surface, and we're gonna put a few dollops of aquarium sealant around the outside. Now, if I recall, the stuff smells really bad. I tried to get a tiny little tube of it, but unfortunately, a local pet store only had the big tubes. So here's what it'll sort of look like. I have the mirror on backwards, but as you can see, it's not very large. That's about the size we're dealing with. There's not much room. It's right up on the edge of that. So, and I'm gonna glue it from the corners. Let's give that a try. It's going to be a little tricky because I have to hold it at an angle. I need something to set this in, a cradle of some type. If you've been enjoying this video, please push the like button. It means the world to little channels like this. All right, so this is just a block of foam.
This foam was part of some package we received a long time ago. That 45 degree angle has come in handy several times.
And that ought to hold it level. This is going to work out well, I think. I'm putting some very light scratches in it just so I know the extents of the hole.
I'm doing this because I can't see how the mirror is centered over the hole once I lay it down. So these lines will help me get it centered.
Get it lined up in those etch marks. I think it's ready for the glue. I'm going to put a little bit of weight on it.
We have to be very careful here. Apply the sealant without moving the mirror or getting any sealant under it.
All right, call it done. Let it sit for 24 hours. Well, here we are 24 hours later. Let's take a close look at this. Looks pretty good. Let's remove it from here so we can look in here and see if any glue seeped around the edges. Well, I don't see any of the glue seeped around the edge. That's pretty good. Let's put it back together. Let's blow it off. See, there's three screws in there, I promise you. Takes a very steady hand. I don't want to drop anything on that mirror. Let's go reattach this to the telescope. See how it works. That is so much better. I lost the pictures of the scratched up mirror before I got it recoated, but boy, does it look perfect right now. Let's go attach this to the telescope. There we go. It's a little bit better lighting. This is the first of many fixes and upgrades that I'll be making to this telescope over the next few months. Now, this is the first time I've ever had access to a really nice Maksutov Cassegrain. And when we're all done with the fixes and upgrades, we'll give it a test on Jupiter and see if this is really the planet killer that they say this type of telescope is. Until then, thanks for watching and clear skies, everybody. One more thing. If you want to see how to properly clean an 8-inch telescope mirror, well, check out this video. And if you want to see how to properly clean a gigantic 14-inch telescope mirror, check out this video. They're both a lot of fun. Well, until next time, I have to go back down to the basement.